Yeah, he was, you know, Logan was an 11-year-old boy, the youngest of all of our nieces and nephews. My brother and his wife, Logan's mother and his father, wonderful parents, very safety conscious. They had an ATV on their property all of Logan's life. That day, my brother had parked his adult-sized ATV in the driveway with an intent to be able to teach his older son, Hunter, how to begin to ride. Logan's mother and her girlfriend just decided to go for a walk. Hunter's in the house working on his online safety certification. Nothing was out of the ordinary. Logan walks outside. The key was in the ignition. Logan was able to get on that machine and he was able to start it up. And he got on that machine and he hit the throttle. And when he did, he grabbed on. There's a short driveway that intersected with a county road. Logan was thinking, don't go into the road. He decided to turn that vehicle and he did it at a high rate of speed. You know, the tires slid and caught the edge of the asphalt, which caused that machine to, well, they figure it flipped in the air. And when it came down, it, you know, Logan sustained a massive head injury that ended his life instantaneously. And they were able to call, you know, Logan's mother, who was, you know, for the love of God, I mean, she was on foot a half a mile away. And the most horrific was my brother, who was notified by the police department while I was at work. And the sheriff's department brought him on scene, and that is not something anybody wants to see, is somebody that, you know, a father of a child or a mother of a child coming on scene to where that accident occurred. And that's really where, you know, the Ride Safe Foundation began, because what happens is for all of us who love Logan and cared for him and protected him, we all asked ourselves, you know, what didn't I do? What didn't I say? If you have this equipment, then the risk is already there. The question isn't whether the risk exists. The question is what are you doing to mitigate that risk?